Hey, Quagmire.
Peter, I want you and the guys to come over to my house right now.
We're drinking. What for?
Just come over. I want you to see something.
All right. Come on, guys. We're going to Quagmire's.
All right, hang on. I gotta go to the bathroom first. Okay, let's go.
Oh, finally! Come on inside.
Well, what is it? What's a big damn deal?
Look.
It's a cat.
Yeah, I just got him today. His name's James. Isn't he just the cutest thing you've ever seen? Hi, James. Oh, my God. Watch when I scratch his bottom. He sticks his fanny in the air. Uh-oh, we have liftoff. Oh, come here, James.
What the hell are we doing?
Quagmire, since when do you like cats?
Since I found this little guy living under my house. I'll tell you this. I understand now why the pharaohs worshipped these animals. Oh, look, Joe, he's making friends. Oh, sorry.
You know what? It's all right, Quagmire. That leg is mostly pus.
Oh, okay, here it comes, James. Here comes the part I was telling you about. Ah, you're one of those.
I hate Quagmire lately.
Me too. That cat has totally changed his personality.
Yeah, like when I went over to his house the other day.
Who is it?
It's me, Quagmire. I need to borrow your lawnmower.
Oh, Quagmire's not here. It's just me, James. I'm supposed to watch the house.
Come on, Quagmire. It's 97 degrees out here. We're two grown men.
Are you selling yarn? Because I love yarn.
No, I need to borrow your lawnmower.
Oh, I don't think Quagmire wants me to do that.
Oh, come on.
I don't think Quagmire appreciated the condition you returned it in last time.
Glenn, can I just...
No, you can't have it. Hey, guys, it's James's birthday tomorrow. Would you all sign his card?
You want us to sign a card for your cat?
Yeah, and don't just put your name. Write something clever.
God, I hate having to come up with something on the spot. Have a mice day. Best fishes. Peter.
Thanks, that's great. Well, I gotta get going. I'm heading off to Vermont to get James's birthday present. There's this neat little store called Catitudes that makes all this neat cat stuff. See you guys later.
What a queer.
He's going all the way to Vermont for cat gifts and whatnot? You can get a scratching post down at Walmart for $2. A pair of Lee jeans for $9. You know they got seats for children now? You put them right in your car? Supposed to make them safer. Only problem is you can't lean your seat all the way back. Oh. We gotta do something about this. His whole life is about that stupid cat.
Hey, you know, the cat's alone at Quagmire's right now. You know what we should do? We should go over there and shave it.
That's a great idea. Let's do it. Let's shave the cat. Oh, boy, I usually only get this excited when they say the title of a movie in the movie.
I'm telling you, these drug dealers represent a clear and present danger to the United States.
He said it.
All I'm saying is, what if this is as good as it gets?
There it is.
The only way for me to solve this crisis is to be Superman 4, The Quest for Peace.
Oh, that's why they call it that.
All right, the cat's gotta be in here.
Hey, let's take a man-sized poop in his cat box so he thinks there's something really wrong with him.
There it is.
Rock and roll!
Yeah, shaving time. All right, hand me the razor.
Oh, my God!
Peter, you killed it!
Well, you guys relax. He's got 8 more lives. Okay, 7 more lives. 6, 5, 4.
Peter, stop doing what you're doing.
What do we do?
All right, I have an idea. How about we hide the cat's body and leave that window open, and that way it'll seem like the cat ran away.
We'll never get away with that.
Oh, we just might. You see, I've got a lucky cat's foot.
You know, Peter, it's sort of adding insult to injury raiding Quagmire's fridge for beer after you killed his cat.
Or is it? Is my response. Crap. I hate cops. Almost as much as I hated my overly sensitive car alarm. Bitch.
What do we got, partner?
Empty alcohol containers. The driver's inebriated and covered in blood. He's got scratches on his face and arms. There's a blood-soaked corpse in the back seat. Got shovels in there. And a hand-drawn map titled, "This is where we'll hide the body."
Well, that all seems fine. Sorry to bother you, sir.
You're under arrest, dirtbag!
Oh, come on! I don't appreciate drug addicts in my town. I'm a family guy.
He said it!
All right, Brian, your family's here to bail you out.
Brian, if you don't mind, we'll start thinking up our prison rape joke immediately. I'll break the ice. Hey, Brian, did you do hard time or hardly working? Penis. All right, well, all the pieces are there. Somebody make something out of that.
Hey, Brian, who is your favorite baseball player? Albert Pujols?
Chris, stop it. Come on. Brian, we're happy you're out of jail. And when we get to the car, would you like a donut to sit on? Oh, you see, I'm part of it. I'm part of it like everyone else.
I can't believe they threw me in jail for a quarter ounce of pot.
Well, Brian, it's your own fault. I mean, pot is illegal for a reason.
Lois, don't be a hypocrite. You've smoked pot.
Well, sure, Brian, but I'm thinking about the children. Pot's illegal mainly to protect them.
No. Pot is illegal because William Randolph Hearst ran a smear campaign against marijuana in the 1930s to protect his interests in the timber industry because hemp was poised to replace wood as an inexpensive raw material for the manufacture of paper.
There's your smear campaign right there, Brian.
Mom's right. Drugs are bad, Brian. I mean, haven't you seen those commercials?
Open up, Brian. It's Joe.
Crap. Just a sec.
Brian, under your probation, you're required to submit to random drug tests. I need some urine.
You mean right now?
Yes, right now. Here's some magazines to get you going.
How's that gonna...
Oh, sorry. It's been a while.
Look, I don't really feel comfortable doing this in front of you.
Fine, I'll wait outside. Here's a bottle of lotion.
Joe...
Right, sorry.
Stewie, I need your urine.
Really?
Yeah, Joe's doing a drug test, and if I give him some of mine, he's gonna know I've been smoking pot, so I need some of your urine so I can... You don't have to be naked for this.
But I don't have to not be naked for it either. Uh-huh.
Come on, Stewie, hurry up and pee. Joe's waiting for me.
Brian, you know I can't go unless you stare at it.
Brian, what the hell?
Hey, Lois.
The jig's up, Brian. Run!
Brian, is this how you're trying to pass your drug test? By stealing a baby's urine? My God, that is just sick!
No, what's sick is making marijuana illegal when it's been proven that it does less damage to you than alcohol.
No, what's sick is the plot of the movie Baby Mama.
What happens when a 40-year-old woman asks her 41-year-old friend to carry her baby?
Push, Angie, push! Push hard! Oh, it's dead.
Brian, when you have to go to these lengths just to get away with smoking pot, it's time to make a change.
You're right, Lois. It is time to make a change.
Thank you.
It's time for Quahog to legalize marijuana.
Well, that's not exactly what I meant.
Hey, check out the size of Stewie's penis.
Oh, come on, guys. It's just the way God made me.
No more oppression. We, as American adults with free will, have the right to use marijuana if we choose to. Enough government profiteering under the guise of morality. Enough with this phony war on drugs.
You know, you're going about this all wrong, Brian. If you want to win people over, you can't just drone on like Ben Stein. You've got to have a little more showmanship. Here, watch.
Now everybody gather round and listen if you would. When I tell you every person needs a way of feeling good. Every kitty needs a ball of string and every dog a stick. But all you need is a bag of weed to really get a kick.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A bag of weed, a bag of weed. Oh, everything is better with a bag of weed. It's the only nut that you'll ever need. Because everything is better with a bag of weed.
There you go, you're all getting it now.
When Texas people want to feel good,
they go assault a queer.
When stupid people need a thrill,
they rent the wrong T. here.
When Michael Jackson needs a rush,
he humps a guy like me.
Right.
But all we need is a bag of weed to keep us worry-free. One, two, three, ho!
Oh, a bag of weed, a bag of weed. Oh, everything is better with a bag of weed. Oh, you don't need pep and you don't need speed, because everything is better with a bag of weed.
Have a go, Brian.
As Mr. H.L. Mencken said, the common man's a fool.
And just like Helen Keller said, do fluky people pool.
But try and use your heads and don't buy into all the fear.
Hey! Cause all we need is a bag of weed to make us wanna cheer. And one, two, a bag of weed, a bag of weed. Oh, everything is better with a bag of weed. You can try and fight, but we're all agreed, because everything is better with a bag of weed.
As mayor of Quahog, I hereby sign into law the legalization of marijuana.
Good evening, everyone. Our top story, marijuana is now legal. Legal in Quahog. And it's made everything just so great. Okay, you can read the next one.
No, you can't.
No, you.
Okay. Let's read it both together.
Okay.
Ready?
Okay. Here's Ollie Williams with a blacky weather forecast. How's the weather look, Ollie?
Not too bad.
Right on.
See, Lois, tell me things in Quahog aren't better now.
It's just weird, Brian. I still don't think I'm comfortable with the whole idea.
Look, Lois, ever since marijuana was legalized, crime has gone down, productivity is up, and ratings for Doctor Who are through the roof.
Yeah, but Pete is so baked lately, he can hardly set up a cutaway.
Man, this is even better than... this is worse than... This better... I don't know. Here's a list of celebrities I don't like.